The visibility of conventional IP MPLS controllers is limited to the IP domain. Diversity can be requested in link layer interconnects, or LLIs, which are connections between routers over optical networks, or in IP services. The intent is to use diverse paths through the network to allow overall resiliency in the event of optical fiber or other failures. However, when using an optical domain for router interconnect, conventional IP MPLS controllers are unaware of the internal topology and physical arrangement of the optical network and of the physical routes that those IP services or LLIs are taking. In reality, the resulting paths may not be truly diverse in the optical domain, and paths that seem diverse in the IP domain may actually take the same optical fiber, or they may take separate fibers that are within the same cable or duct, hence sharing risk. Under these circumstances, a cut in a shared fiber, cable, or duct will impact both IP services and LLIs. The Nokia Network Services Platform application, Cross-Domain Coordinator, can perform real-time diversity analysis for IP services or LLIs traversing an optical network. The end-to-end path diversity is checked, and NSP will highlight any shared risk that would prevent the desired diversity constraints from being met, thus allowing true end-to-end diversity to be established as required. This increases resiliency, avoids unnecessary outages, and maintains high quality of service and quality of experience. This demonstration shows the NSP Cross-Domain Coordinator application performing an end-to-end IP service diversity analysis. The workflow for LLI diversity analysis is very similar. The results of the diversity analysis will be shown, and techniques for finding the root cause for diversity analysis failure will be given. IP services that are to be analyzed for diversity are associated in groups using the service fulfillment application. Once these groups are defined, a diversity analysis can be performed using the cross-domain coordinator application. The progress status of the diversity analysis is shown, and a report is displayed showing details such as groups scanned, groups meeting diversity constraints, groups failing diversity constraints, start time, and end time. Once the analysis is complete, a list of groups failing the diversity constraints is displayed. If there are violations for certain groups, they are marked as fail with the appropriate reason. The reason for failure can be link constraints failure, implying a shared optical fiber, or shared risk link group constraints failure, implying a shared cable or duct. You can select a particular group and overlay the respective IP services on the IP optical map to see the physical path taken by each of the IP services. Each of these paths is displayed in a different color, while links that are common to both IP services are shown in black. These links represent a root cause for diversity analysis failure. You can also add a particular group to a list of known exceptions. This prevents the group from appearing as a failure in the subsequent diversity analysis runs. A detailed report is generated on the successful execution of the diversity analysis. You can download the last generated report at any time. The report contains a summary of the run and lists all of the groups which were successful or failed, as well as the groups that were added to the exception list. IP service or LLI diversity may be apparent at the IP layer, but deeper insights into the optical infrastructure can reveal shared risks. This can happen where two apparently diverse paths traverse a common optical infrastructure. The NSP can identify shared risks to ensure that required diverse paths are truly diverse, bringing increased resiliency, reduced service outages, and high quality of service and quality of experience.